All right. Very, very good morning to everyone. And a hearty welcome to this fantastic program that we are having this month. November, as we celebrate, is the National Adoption Month. A very pious deed indeed. And adoption by far has come a long way in Indian history. And how parents have seen adoption and how generations have seen adoption has changed over a period of time. And it's amazing to have such fabulous panelists here. We have Dr. Aloma Lobo and we have Mrs. Radha Nagesh who are here. Radha Nagesh is an expert in adoption. And Dr. Aloma, what can I say about you? I can write verses on what you have done so far. And I can't keep going on because I'll let you talk about the entire process. But in any case, before I move on, I'd like to give a quick glimpse to our beautiful audience about the fabulous speakers that we have. Let me quickly introduce Mrs. Radha Nagesh. Radha Nagesh is a trained emotional counselor, and since 2006, she has volunteered with Viveka Center for Emotional Support based in Bangalore, India. For over 25 years, Radha has deeply engaged in child welfare by effective positive change for children waiting in institutions and bringing a paradigm shift to child-centric thinking. She empowers adoptive parents with skills to parent children who have been abused, neglected, or traumatized. Her training also focuses on family dynamics, older child preparation, and counseling interventions in adoption disruptions. She is a life member volunteer at KSCCW, which is Karnataka State Council for Child Welfare in Bangalore. Radha initiated and has successfully been running a counseling center at KSCCW, which is an outreach initiative serving the beneficiaries of the NGO and the underprivileged. Her advanced diploma in counseling psychology from the College of Allied Educators in Singapore. She completed perseverance training of foster, adoptive, and kinship caregivers by LAMB International in Canada in 2018. Fabulous achievements. There's nothing that we can talk about, but we're very, very delighted to have you here, Mrs. Radha Nagesh. I will pass the mic over to you. But before that, let me quickly take a few minutes to introduce Dr. Aloma Lobo. Dr. Aloma is a pediatrician, mother, and a spokesperson. Dr. Lobo is a beacon of light and hope for numerous childless couples and parentless children. As former chairperson of ACA, Adoption Coordinator Agency, she has vast understanding of the intricacies of adoption in India and abroad that spans over 30 years. Dr. Lobo has even worked with St. John's Hospital and World Health Organization in various adoption-related projects. Author of the best-selling book, Penguin Guide to Adoption in India, she and her husband adopted 3 girls after the birth of their third son. That's really, really brave. That is so awesome. An advocate of child safety and parental guidance, Dr. Lobo believes that adoption is not just about building a home with a new child. It's a long process that requires understanding for which counseling is a necessity. Her daughter, Nisha, who suffers from a rare genetic condition, also known as ichthyosis, yet that never deterred the family from supporting and helping her bloom into a strong woman she is today. Her zeal and enthusiasm to give a safe haven and solace to families and children have paved way for numerous new initiatives and policies in the field of adoption. A true legendary woman, Dr. Aloma Lobo, this is you're an inspiration to one and all. And we are so delighted to have you here this adoption month. I mean, who could be a more ideal guest than you? Thank you so much for being here. Over to Mr. Basavraj, if you would like to quickly introduce the speakers or to talk about the program today. Mr. Basavraj, are you here? Sir, you're muted. Could you please mute yourself?
Ellarigu namaskara. Basavraj, program manager Sara, director of child protection, Bangalore. ಈಗಿನ ನಾವು ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ದತ್ತು ಮಾಸಾಚರಣೆ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನವೆಂಬರ್ ತಿಂಗಳು ಸಾಮಾನ್ಯವಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಮಹಿಳಾ ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ದತ್ತು ಸಮಯ ಮಾಸಾಚರಣೆಯನ್ನು ಹಮ್ಮಿಕೊಂಡಿರುವ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟಿವ್ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಈ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆದಂತಹ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಲಾಮೋ ಲೋಬೋ ಅವರು ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮೆಂಟರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ರಾಧಾ ನಾಗೇಶ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟಿವ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಕೆಎಸ್ ಸಿಸಿಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು ಅಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟಿವ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಸಾರಾ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ಗೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿರುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೌಹೃದಯಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾನು ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನು ಕೋರ್ತೇನೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ತಮ್ಮ ಅನುಭವಗಳನ್ನ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ತಾವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಯಶಸ್ವಿಗೊಳಿಸಬೇಕಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಈ ಮೂಲಕ ನಾನು ಮನವಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸರ್. ಮೇಡಮ್ ರಾಧಾ ನಾಗೇಶ್, ವುಡ್ ಯು ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಓವರ್?
First and foremost, thank you so much, ICPS Government of Karnataka, for giving a chance, and I'm really overwhelmed to be sharing this platform with Dr. Aloma. So Dr. Aloma, we have known each other for I don't know more than 3 decades, a little over 3 decades. So may I request you to initiate this? Yes, please. And we'll take it on from there. And we have help. Let us look at the kind of comments that we are going to get in. And let us see. We'll take it from the participation. There will be people are participating. So over to you, Dr. Aloma.
Thank you, Radha. Thank you so much. It's such a pleasure to be here today, and thank you for having me on this forum. Thank you very much. I think I just wanted to add one little thing. One of my greatest experiences in adoption, I think, was when I was chairperson of CARA, and I think I learned so much from everybody over there at that time, and it has stood me in good sense, in good stead all these years. Now, the topic for today was the importance of pre-adoptive counseling. You know, many people have said to me, why should we go for pre-adoptive counseling? I mean, if we were going to have a child biologically, we wouldn't have to go for any kind of counseling. To some extent, that is true. To some extent, that is certainly true. But at the same time, adopting a child is a totally different, it's totally different. You are prepared differently. Your family is prepared differently. You think differently. You have so many fears and concerns. Your families have fears and concerns. You wonder, will I love this child? Like if it was my own biological child. And at this very moment, I would say to you that family is not about blood. Family is about relationship. What makes a family is not blood. What makes a family is relationship. I know that. Now, and yet many people have fears and they wonder, how do we go about this? And when you go into pre-adoptive counseling, right from the time the home study starts, and you say, should we adopt? Why should we adopt? Am I making the right decision? That husband and wife may have different thoughts on the matter. Your family may have different thoughts on the matter. Should I bring my parents into it? Should I bring my in-laws into it? And maybe we will have a child in the near future. Maybe, we will have a biological child soon. Should we do this? So the first thing when you go into pre-adoptive counseling is come to terms with the fact that you have not had a child for whatever reason. It's not really the important thing. You have not had a child, and is this what we want to do? Have we come to terms with the fact that we have had a certain amount of loss, and have we come to terms with it, and can we move on? I'm just going to go into it in a nutshell. Number one. Number two, are we adopting for the right reason? It's because we have just lost a child, because there is inheritance on the way, maybe because there is pressure from family. Are we adopting for the right reason? And there's only one reason why you would want to adopt a child, and that is because you want to become parents. To my mind, that's the only thing. Have you come to terms with that? Then again, there are wrong reasons to adopt. Have you come to terms with those wrong reasons? Has someone told you about it? Your home study is going to be done, and you're going to ask a million questions. You must ask them, but this is the time to get over all your concerns. Then you want to know what happens when the child comes home. What do I do when the child comes home? What do I do when a referral is made? What is the process all about? You have not understood the process properly. Then again, at referral, how do I know what happens with the health of the child? Can I see the child? Can I book the child? Can I take the child for testing, for et cetera? What happened in the early days? I'm terrified. A couple came to me just a few days ago and they said to me, you know, we're expecting a referral in the very near future. We're terrified. And she said, we're terrified. Maybe we should cancel. I said, oh no, it's quite okay to be terrified. She said, it's okay. I said, I was terrified. And I said, it's normal to be terrified. And I said, oh my gosh, this helps so much. So it helps to talk to someone to get counseling. What happens when my child goes to school? Do I tell my child that he or she is adopted? How do I tell my child? I'm adopting an older child. What will happen? Shouldn't my child be grateful that we're taking her in? You know, what do we know about the birth parents? What do we know if the child has any condition? What do we do? Can we give the child back, rather? Can we give the child back? We are giving the child back. What are the various issues that might occur? How do I differentiate between regular, ordinary growing up issues and just adolescent issues and adoption issues? You know, these are the things that you might want to go through with your pre-adoptive counseling. And it's essential, I think, today to give yourself that opportunity, not just for you, but also for the sake of the growth of your child. That's a rather big nutshell, but that's what it is.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Very, very true, Aloma. Absolutely. I completely agree with what you said. And so, yes, as a counselor, I have also faced this very many times. You know, when do we really need to be taught how to parent a child? Is there any difference after all? It's the same having a biological child and an adopted child. But there is that wee bit difference because these children who come into the fold of adoption are coming into the fold of adoption differently. So we need to be prepared. We need to educate ourselves. So counseling is all about preparation and education. And it helps. It helps to be a parent is always a better parent who is, you know, prepared better. Very simple. And it applies even typically in any family for that matter. So like Dr. Lobo said, who are these children who come into the fold of adoption? You know, who are the people who need counseling? Is it only parents? We have social workers who have joined in today. And how are they looking at pre-adoptive counseling? What are the kind of issues that they face? Is it very simple? Are they able to pick up nuances when they are meeting parents? Are they able to pick up the relationship between the spouse? Are they able to pick up the attachment style that they have? These are very simple things. It goes a very, very long way. So my dear social workers who are there, at any point of time, you are, you know, you are at crossroads. At any point of time, there is a, you're not too sure about a family, please seek help too. Please talk to more people. Please talk to your group of social workers. It's very important. Why? It is the question of the life of a child. We cannot play with the life of a child by just placing, because the system says, place the child. And then after 2 months, like, Dr. Lobo just mentioned, you feel that the child doesn't fit in and you return the child. This is not Amazon. You know, we really, really need to be mindful, the parents, the waiting parents, as well as the social workers, the SARS, the CCIs. It is about the child's life. Be there, be in sync, be attuned with the child before placing the child in adoption. Sandesh, is there anything quickly you would like to put across in Canada? That would, I'll be really grateful to you.
Yeah. Ellarigu namaskara. Igagle Aloma madam matte Radha Nagesh held hage adoption annodu ondu sakaratmakavada ondu kriye where now ondu maguna mane karkon bandaga ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್ಗೂ ಇದು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ವೇರ್ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಒಂದ್ಸರ್ತಿ ನೋಡ್ಲೇಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ, ಈ ಮಗು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೊಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತಾ ಈ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದು ದೃಢವಾದ ಒಂದು ನಿರ್ಧಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಬರಬೇಕು ನಾವು ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗೂ ಅನ್ಯಾಯ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು, ಮಗುಗೂ ಅನ್ಯಾಯ ಆಗಬಾರ್ದು. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದ್ಸರ್ತಿ ಮಗು ನಾವು ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಅಮೆಝಾನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ತಗೊಂಡಾಗಿರೋ ವಸ್ತು ತರ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಅದೇ ತರನೇ ನಾವು ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.
So, do we have any questions that has come up in YouTube and Facebook that we can take up from there on?
Ma'am, before we head to the questions there, I have a few questions to you myself.
Yes,
so,
please.
When is the best age for a couple to think of adoption? Is there an age, or is it a thought? Is it an attitude? What is it? What is it that drives people to adopt? Dr. Lobo, I think you will be the best person to tell me, because you've adopted three kids yourself.
I think the best, there's no best time. For me, the best time was when we were still fairly young. When I say fairly, it's a very relative thing today. My children think I'm as old as the hills. But when you're fairly young, but I think the most, and our first two children came to us when we were in our early 30s. And our last daughter came to us remarkably when we were quite a bit older. And I think, but somehow we were more mature, we were more settled in everything. Our careers were behind us, everything was settled economically, financially, we were fine. Our relationship was good. It's always been good, but it was even better. And I think that made for a very much more satisfying, enjoyable parenting time. Oh, also because five others had left. So that also is that. So, you know, I think there's no right, to my mind, I don't think there's a right age. It's the right time in your own mind when you think, I am ready for it. This is what I want to do. What do you think, brother?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely, Aloma. It is all about having the right attitude. It is all about telling oneself over and over, adoption is permanent. You know, that is the most important thing. It is all about accepting the child wholeheartedly and giving that child that unconditional love. There is no looking back. Once the decision is taken, the child is yours. It is. Yeah.
Excellent. That's a fabulous thought to carry back. So although there is no ideal age, now when couple get married and they discover that they cannot have children, so that's when, you know, all of these thoughts start probing their minds. I know of another couple who had decided that they're going to have only one biological child and adopt the other one. And they started the process just when the first biological, when the lady conceived the first biological child. And I think as a woman, that's a phenomenal, achievement. And rather, it's an inspiration, and how her thought process has been is excellent to even think of. But as a woman, it's always hard to just have my own opinion and convince the entire family. So how important is the entire family in the adoption process? Because a child is coming home. It's not just to the woman.
Oh, well, I think the most important thing is, first of all, to husband and wife to be in sync with what they want to do and their thoughts. They've cleared all their doubts, their fears. And it is very important, especially in our Indian context, to bring your family into not the decision-making as much as to the information aspect of it. Now, I always feel that if you live as a single family, as a nuclear family, you make your decision and you go through with it. But if you live with a joint family, I do believe, in my own opinion, that it's important to get everybody else on board. And we've had many families who were not for any negative reason, but they just were fearful of what it might be. And they've come to us, we've talked with them, we've introduced them to members of our family and to other families for them to see that, you know, it's okay, it's normal. It's a normal relationship process. So yes, it is important to bring your parents into the information of the whole thing. And I, like my own father at first was not happy about it. But the first time he held his first granddaughter in his arms, he had tears streaming down his face. And after that, I was out of the picture for the next 2 hours. So within our Indian context, yes, it's important to have your family informed about what you're going to do. especially if it's a joint family.
Dr. Lupo, you've been stressing on the point that it is important to be informed. But here in our Indian context, it's more of seeking permission rather than information, because we can't afford to give our parents information and do away with it, because we all live in a very close-knit circle. Moreover, our parents are our support system at all times. How do we tackle this? What can I say? It's a thin line between giving information and taking permission.
I think somewhere along the line, the permission is automatic if they know about it. And I think if you're living in a joint family and if a family is not happy about it, I think they have to wait to adopt. Because it's a child coming into an environment of a hostile environment, that's not a good idea. And it's like permission, I meant information, and hopefully permission follows information. Yeah. Yeah. True. I didn't have to do either. So because I lived in a nuclear family anyway. Yeah. It also depends on how your family, what your family dynamics are like.
Excellent.
Absolutely.
Mrs. Radha Nagesh, would you like to add to what Dr. Lobo said? Because I think in the Indian context, this is very, very pertinent that we talk about our family structures and family accepting the child wholeheartedly. The mother may, the father may, to a large extent, but the grandparents accepting a child which does not biologically belong to them is a huge mental shift. So how do you handle such situations? I'm sure you've come across such situations.
Oh, yes, very many times. Yeah. Personal life as well as, meeting more families, adoptive families. I think it's very important for us to understand, like the South African, the saying goes, It takes a village to raise a child. It is for the couple to first accept it, and it's important. It's important to be, what are we doing? What is adoption anyway? We are providing a family for the child. You know, the entire family is there for this particular child. So it starts there with the adoptive, the couple who's going to adopt. Once they understand that I need all of them, the language comes on its own. Of course, you have to. Permission is a very heavy word. We don't take permission to have biological children. So you tell them politely, with respect, with reverence, about your decision to expand your family. This is how I'm going to be expanding my family. And it works. It works very well. Give them time to the immediate reaction, like you mentioned about the seniors, the parents and the in-laws, is not as much about the child who's going to join in. It's about their own children, and that is these adoptive parents. How are you going to handle this huge responsibility of bringing up someone else's child as your own? You know what I mean? It is huge. It's heavy. So the parents need to be in sync. Like Lobo said, the parents need to be attuned with their feelings and be confident, and then take the next step. Things fall in place. Give yourself some time. Let things evolve. Let this new idea of expanding the family, seep in into people. Be positive. This is not charity. No. Adoption is not charity. If we are lucky that our children give us an opportunity to parent them, to nurture them, that is the beauty of adoption.
Excellent. So it's not just about the parents or the family. No. It's also about the child accepting the family. So is there God forbid, but in case there is a situation where the child is uncomfortable in the situation, so if it's a newborn, or if it's a very small, if it's an infant, the situation is largely different. But if it's a grown-up child and the child is uncomfortable in the situation, so how can that be handled? Do they have support groups where they can reach out and say, I'm uncomfortable in this situation? Can you do something about it?
It's the other way around, actually. If the child is uncomfortable, who's the adult in this relationship? We, as parents, we are the adults. We need to look into what is it that's making the child uncomfortable? What is the meaning behind this behavior? actually important. What is it? It is not just providing food, shelter. It is beyond that. You need to be there for the child. Of course, the child might, slightly older children, of course, they're going to have behavioral issues. And that is the only language they have. They don't have that developed vocabulary. They don't have that language to tell you, you know what, I'm feeling very sad. You know what, I'm missing. No, they are going to behave differently like any other child behaves in a very typical family. So there's nothing different. It's just for the parents to pick up. It is for the parents to pick up what is happening. And regarding support group, I, for one, always tell the parents, be in touch with more parents. Make your own smaller groups. Be in touch. Do not judge families. Just be there. It's going to make a lot of difference to yourself and for your children who have joined through adoption. Aluma?
Yeah, I think I fully endorse what you just said. That is, it's not the child who's uncomfortable. There's something about, it's the parent who have to look deep into themselves and say, are we doing something, can we do something differently? You're not necessarily doing anything wrong. Can we do something differently? This usually would happen with an older child that comes into the home. And at first, everybody expects the child to be so grateful for the change in environment. But children are always nervous about change. Their security, whatever their security was worth at that particular point of time, was being in the agency. And, you know, that was what they were familiar with. Coming into a totally different environment, their security goes out of the window. And the sense of security, rather. And children very often at that stage say, I want to go back. And it's up to us parents to decide how we can do things differently, as Radha rightly said. But sometimes when children have grown up in the family, be they biological or be they adopted, at some stage they say, we want to go. I'm going to my grandmother's house. I don't want to stay with you. Or I'm going to, other people's mothers are quite different from you. We want to go there. Or we want to, you know, children do that all the time. That's manipulation also. And so it doesn't just happen with children who are adopted, and it can happen with children who are biological as well. And sometimes some children fantasize about their birth parents at some stage and think, especially when they refuse something or they're reprimanded over something, they fantasize that perhaps their birth parents would not have done it this way, they would have done it differently. What the bottom line here is adequate communication. And sometimes all that a child needs when he says, I want to go away, is to bring him close to you and to give him a warm hug. And say, you're not going anywhere because I'm not going anywhere. And this is where you are going to be because I love you. And this is where you're going to be. And that has worked wonders with a lot of children, especially around the ages of 7 or 8, you know, who are very unsure of what they want to do, where they want to go. And this new food, these new names, these new people, this new type of toilet, this new, everything is new, you know. And it has happened, yes. But we have to change, as Radha said, you know, how we deal with the situation. We have made someone else uncomfortable for whatever reason.
ರೈಟ್ ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಅವರೇ ನೀವು ಈ ವಿಷಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಒಂದೆರಡು ಮಾತು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಸುಮಾರು ಕನ್ನಡ ಕೇಳುವಂತ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತ ಕನ್ನಡಿಗರು ತುಂಬಾ ಜನ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇದನ್ನ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೀವು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ.
ಖಂಡಿತ. ರಾಧಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲುಮಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೇಳ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ ಮಗು ಯಾವತ್ತಿದ್ರು ಮಗುನೆ. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ವಾತಾವರಣಕ್ಕೆ ಬಂದಾಗ ಅದು ಹೊಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಟೈಮ್ ಬೇಕೇ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಹೊಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ದೇ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಕಾರಣ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಯಾವ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೆ ಅದು ಹೊಂದ್ಕೋತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಏನ್ ಕಾರಣಕ್ಕೆ ಅದು ಹೊಂದ್ಕೋತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಇವಾಗ ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ದಿವಸ ಇದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಬಂದಾಗ್ಲೂ
Mrs. Radha Nagesh and Dr. Lobo, we've had some fantastic conversations with them and also very interesting thoughts for children as well as parents. I'm sure a lot of parents and grandparents are watching this program and they are here asking you more and more questions. Now, before we get there, let's understand the basic process. Mrs. Radha Nagesh, could you please briefly tell us the process of adoption? I know we're talking about the importance of counseling today. Nevertheless, we must know the process. So for new parents aspiring to adopt, what is it that they should think of first, and whom should they talk to first? What is the process? Where does it all start? Ma'am, you're muted.
Where does it all start is a beautiful question. I want to tell all of you who are watching, the social workers as well as parents who are waiting. Adoption is not a band-aid. It is not a band-aid for depression. It is not a band-aid for loss in your family. It is not going to fix marriage. You're bringing home a child. So please be aware. Please give it a thought before even you think of adoption. One, for some reason, a couple had to go through fertility issues. 5 years, 10 years, 15 years. And then there is this decision to take going for adoption. It cannot be a plan B. It has to be a plan A. I tried all of this. I tried, taking a child from my family. I tried taking a child without letting anyone know. All of this didn't work. Hence, let me register and get a child. Doesn't work that way. So parents need to be very, very clear in their thoughts as to what is it that is driving them to adopt a child. What is it? What is the feeling that why do they feel that they can expand the family through adoption? Everything starts there. You know, and that is where adoptive counseling plays a major, major role. Adoption procedure now is much, much better. And that is Dr. Aloma's, where she was in Tara. Aloma, can you please take it from here?
Like I said, the process certainly begins with you. The process begins with you. Once you've made your decision to adopt, then you need to really get someone to talk with. I think it's important to talk with someone about adoption, why you want to adopt, and get associated with an agency in your area that can advise you with all the things that you, a social worker in your area. Then you need, I won't go into details of the process. That's very, very clear on the CARA website, and I can't do better than that. So in a nutshell, in a small peanut nutshell, you know, it's just that you decide to you register. And they will, and you say where you are, and they will ask you to get your home study done. They will tell you where you can get your home study done, if you closest to you, or you can ask Kara for, you can tell Kara where you want to get your home study done. Then you inform the agency, and the agency will get all your paperwork done, your home study done. They will upload it for you, and all your documentation will be uploaded. You get a I don't know why it's called priority number. That doesn't make too much of sense to me. It should just be a number. They give you what they call a priority number, and then you're on your way. Then what happens is you do have to wait. There's a waiting period, and there is a certain amount of certification on their part that has to be done about your documentation. I won't call it certification, approval of your documentation that has to be done. And once the waiting starts, there's not much you can do except smile and grin and bear it. It takes about 2 years, I think now, a little more. And once you get a referral, in today's contest, you're given 72 hours, right? 72 hours to say A or nay. And once the referral is done, then you if you say yes, then you're given the number of the agency, and you contact them and you tell them when you will come to see the child. They will have to give you an approval. Then they give you a child in temporary foster care, not in temporary, in foster care. If you approve of the child, if you agree to take the child, you bring the child home while the agency involved with the courts in your certification process, legalization process. Is that clear enough, Rara? That's very short. But I don't want to go into details. Yeah, but the details are all on the CARA website. Yeah.
Fabulous. So that's it looks like a fairly simple process, but I'm sure for people who are going through this, it's largely.
Actually, you may interrupt you. The process is not complicated. It's the waiting and the time lapses that people find a bit
complicated.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Process itself is not so bad. Am I right, Radha?
Yeah, that's right.
So, Mrs. Radha and Dr. Lobo, there is a question that has been largely looming in my mind for many years, and I really think that this is a golden opportunity for me to ask the experts today. And I'm sure a lot of people here in the audience also have similar questions like me. So, there are so many children who are orphans in this country or around the world. Why is it that the waiting period is so enormous and the number of children available in the adoption centers are so few? Why is it that all these orphans can't find homes? Can we not go ahead and adopt a child just like that? Why is the waiting period when there are so many children who are orphans?
English question.
Sorry.
Okay. Let me put it this way. Radha, would you like to go first this time? Or should I go?
You may, Aluma.
Actually, it's a misnomer. It's a misconception that there are lots of orphan children sitting around. There are not lots of orphan children. There are lots of children in need of care and protection. That is true. But many of the children who are truly orphaned, first of all, may not be in institutions that have a license for adoption. But the number of children, again, in a little nutshell, the number of children who are truly available for adoption are much fewer because there aren't that many orphans who have been cleared for adoption. Many of the children sit in homes where they do not have a license for adoption. Then again, many of the other children have one parent or a grandparent and have not really been relinquished, was given up for adoption. Am I right, Radha? So the number of children that actually have access to adoption institutions are much fewer than the number of total children that are in need of care and protection and are in various homes all over the country.
Okay. Okay. So, yeah, I mean, absolutely, I have nothing else to ask you because you've cleared my questions right away. Sandeshare, ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಇದನ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸುಮಾರು ಜನ ಇದೇ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರೋ ಕನ್ನಡಿಗರು ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಅವ್ರು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಈ ವಿಷಯಗಳನ್ನ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಅಬೌಟ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್
ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್?
ಯಾ. ಸೊ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ಇದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಇಷ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅನಾಥ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಬಟ್ ಆದರೂ ಈ ವೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಒಂದು 2-3 ವರ್ಷ ಯಾಕಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅಲೋಮಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ರಾಧಾ ನಾಗೇಶ್ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ ಹಾಗೆ, ಒಂದು ಮಗು ಅನಾಥ ಅಂತ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಸಪೋಸ್ ಆದ್ರಿದ್ದು ಗ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಅಜ್ಜ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ಒಬ್ರು ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಅದನ್ನ ಅನಾಥ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ. ಅಂತ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಕೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ವಿಭಾಗ ಇದೆ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದು, ಆ ಕೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಮಗು ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದು ಕಾನೂನು ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಅದು ಆ ಮಗು ದತ್ತು ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋವರೆಗೂ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ದತ್ತು ಪ್ರಕ್ರಿಯೆಗೆ ಒಳಪಡಿಸೋದಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಆ ಸಮಯ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಈ ಕೇರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಂದ ಅನಾಥ ಅಂತ ಡಿಕ್ಲೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಲೀಗಲಿ ಕಾನೂನು ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಆ ಮಗು ದತ್ತುಗೆ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋವರೆಗೂ ಆ ಮಗು ನಾವು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ಗೆ ಕೊಡೋದಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಆ ಟೈಮ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ಗೋಸ್ಕರ ತುಂಬಾ ಟೈಮ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಇದು ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಇದೆ, ಕಾರ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಒಂದ್ಸರ್ತಿ ನೀವು ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಮಗು ನಿಮ್ ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಸಬ್ಮಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅದು ಒಂದು ವೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಆ ವೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಪೀರಿಯಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕಾಯ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಒಂದ್ ಟೈಮ್ ರೆಫರಲ್ ಬಂದೇ ಬರುತ್ತೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಅವರೇ. ಮತ್ತೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಟುಡೇ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 5 or 6 years ಆಫ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ನೋ ಇಟ್ ದ ಪೀರಿಯಾಡಿಕ್ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಮಾನಿಟರಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ಸೊ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಎವ್ರಿ 3 years ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಮಾನಿಟರಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಏಜೆನ್ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಅಹೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಏಜೆನ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟಿವ್ ಏಜೆನ್ಸೀಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಏಜೆನ್ಸೀಸ್ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಓ ಹೂಎವರ್ ಇಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್ they have to do a due diligence after every 3 years to find out if everything is going smooth and all right. So what do you have to say about this?
Okay, I just hope my obstetrician who delivered my 3 other boys doesn't turn up on my doorstep to ask me how the boys are doing. So actually, I think when you do a home study and when you do all the due diligence before a child adopts, that's to a great extent necessary, then there certainly are follow-ups for up to two years. But if you're ever going to say that you are a family, we cannot go monitoring you for the rest of your life, for my life or the child's life. I do believe that after a certain period of time, when the agency is sufficiently satisfied that everything is going well, you have to step back. And if there are any issues, if there are any problems, it's the parents who have to deal with it. Now, keep in mind, parents of the problems after 5 to 6 years can occur with any child. I'm not even going to call them problem. I'm going to call them certain parenting challenges.
Challenges, absolutely.
Yeah. They can occur with any child. And you ask Radha or me, have you ever had challenges with our children? Of course. We've all had some kind of challenge at some time or the other, but that's what it means to be a family. And I think to isolate the fact and say, because this child has been adopted, that there are so many more challenges, is not really a good thing to say. It's not even real. It's not even true. Like, but again, to come back to your question, no, I don't think monitoring on a long-term basis is necessary or even judicious.
And also practically impossible, I suppose, right? Because there are so many adoptive parents, so many children being adopted every year. And as an agency, it becomes harder and harder for people to monitor them regularly or to keep updates, right?
But even then, monitoring on a long-term basis, besides being rather difficult, I don't think it is the right thing to do also. You're sticking your nose into someone's family all the time, which is, excuse my French, but that's exactly what
happens. You just feel like you're being watched.
Yeah. And can you imagine some kid who just had a fight with his mother? What he tells, he's going to tell the social worker who turns up and he's 12 years old.
True.
You know, all kids, you know, go through difficult times with their parents at any time. Any kid, yeah. All my six have at some time, with me mainly.
That's an excellent one, Dr. Lobo. ಈ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಕೇಳಿದೆ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದ್ ಜನ ಆಡಿಯನ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಈ ನಿಮ್ ಒಬ್ರು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರನೆ ಈ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆನ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇವ್ರನ್ನ ಕೇಳಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ, ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಇದನ್ನ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾಡಿದಾಗೆ ನನಗ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬರ್ದಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಬಟ್ ಆದ್ರೆ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಇದನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಮಕ್ಕಳು ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗೆ ಬಂದಾದ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಪರಿವಾರದ ಒಂದು ಭಾಗ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಪರಿವಾರನ ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ರು ಬಂದು ನೋಡಿ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ ತಪ್ಪಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಹಂಗಾಗ್ತಿದೆ ಹಿಂಗಾಗ್ತಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳದಕ್ ಯಾರಿಗೂ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಯಾರಾದ್ರೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಪರಿವಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ನಮಗ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವ್ ಇದನ್ ಸರಿಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ನಮಗ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವ್ ಕೇಳ್ತೀವಾ? ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಅದೇ ತರ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಅವ್ರು ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆಗ್ ಬಂದ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವ್ರ ನಮ್ಮನೆಯ ಒಂದು ಭಾಗ, ನಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಭಾಗ, ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಯ ಒಂದು ಭಾಗ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ಅವರನ್ನ ಪದೇ ಪದೇ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಮಾನಿಟರ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೇಳೋದಾಗ್ಲಿ, ಈ ತರ ಅವ್ರು ಸರಿಗಿದಾರ ಅಂತ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾಗ್ಲಿ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇರಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಲೋಬೋ ಅವರು ತುಂಬಾ ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಲೋಬೋ.
ಒಂದ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಆಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಐ ಮೀನ್, ಕಾರಾ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಒಂದು ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಇದೆ ಕಾರಾಗೆ. ಒಂದ್ ಮಗು ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅಪ್ ಟು 2 ಇಯರ್ಸ್, 2 ವರ್ಷ ತನಕ ಅವ್ರು ಮಾನಿಟರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಆ ಮಗು ಹೊಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ, ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅವರು ಹೇಗೆ ಪರಿವಾರ ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಗೆ ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟಿದ್ದು. ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೂ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕಾರದ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಪರಿವಾರದ್ದು ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ.
ಓಕೆ, ಓಕೆ, ಫ್ಯಾಂಟಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಎನಿ ಅದರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್?
Adoption is a lifelong experience, you know, just like, you know, we people don't just mature one fine day and say, oh, we are all adults. You know, it's the same. The child, it's the same with these children who have joined families through adoption. They don't just wake up one day and say, I'm finished thinking about adoption. It is going to come in stages at every point of time in that life. And who's the adult in this relationship? We as parents, we need to be there. It's okay to have issues. Life cannot be a completely smooth road. It's fine. At times it's a little more. At times it's not so much. Some families face it a little more. Some do not. We need to introspect. We need to ask ourselves, what is the meaning behind this behavior? If we do not have the capacity to handle, reach out to more parents. There is, please don't attach shame to it. Reach out to more parents. Maybe just hearing other parents' story somewhere would help you, you know. So be together. Don't just be a little more, you know, work on relationship with other families. And that is, you will be role modeling to your children how important it is. We are just with so many people. We have no issues with friends, you know. So, and why is that? That's because we just accept them for who they are and what they are. Accept your children for what they are. Give them some time. Once the child joins your family, when, you know, during adolescence, of course, the child is going to ask, who am I? Where did I come from? Why was I rejected by my birth mother? You know, and all of us go through this identity. Who am I? What is the purpose of me in this life? What am I going to do in this world? all of us, each one of us go through it. So we have the right, and the adopted children also have the right to go through it. Stand by them. Just be there. We don't need to give huge lectures all the time. At times, just a hug. Like Dr. Aloma said, at times, just be there. Make eye contact. Give the child a hug. That's all they require, probably. Not words every time. It's not difficult. You know, it's not impossible. But yes, difficult road here and there is fine. That's life. Makes you a better person. Go walk with your child.
ಅಬ್ಸಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ನಮ್ದೇ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬಯೋಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳೇ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ ಜೊತೆ ಜಗಳ ಆಡದೆ ಇರ್ತಾರ ಅಂತ ರಾಧಾ ನಾಗೇಶ್ವರ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ. ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಡೆನೂ ಇದ್ದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಅಡೋಲೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ರೀಚ್ ಆದಂಗೆ, ಟೀನೇಜ್ ರೀಚ್ ಆದಂಗೆ, ಅವರ ಜೊತೆ ಇರೋ ಸಂಬಂಧ, ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಜೊತೆ ಇರೋ ಸಂಬಂಧ ತುಂಬಾ ತುಂಬಾ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಆಗೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅವ್ರ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಟಿ, ಅವ್ರ ಗುರುತು, ಅವ್ರು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಅವ್ರು ಹುಡುಕ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಲೋಬೋ, ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಒನ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 3 ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಓನ್ ಅಂಡ್ 3 ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್. ಹೌ ಡಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್? ಹೌ ಡು ದೇ ಮಿಂಗಲ್? ಸೊ ಯು ನೋ, ವೆನ್ ವಿ ವರ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಆರ್ ಸಿಬ್ಲಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಯು ನೋ ದಿ ಓಲ್ಡರ್ ಸಿಬ್ಲಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ದಿ ಯಂಗರ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಚ್. ಯು ನೋ, ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಫನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್, ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಚುಯೇಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಹಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಇನ್ ರಿಯಲ್. ಹೌ ಡು ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಲ್ ದಿಸ್?
Okay, let me make one little correction here. You said you have 3 of your own and 3 are adopted. Actually, I don't have 3 of my own and 3 are adopted. I have 6 of my own.
Wow.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. We'll have to give all you a standing ovation. Yes.
All 6 of my own. And you know, kids, I think somewhere along the line, kids are always worrying each other, teasing each other. But the thing of saying you're adopted, no, that didn't happen here, because it was a fact of our families. It wouldn't have been a joke. It wouldn't have been funny. It wouldn't have bothered anybody, because it's a fact in our family. And we always grew up with these two words, you know, you came here, you came through adoption, you were born, you went to the hospital. So in our family, the word adoption was never a bad word. It was just a word that was heard way too many times, and they were fed up of it. You know, and so, but the brothers and the sisters, it was the usual brother-sister thing. The brothers teased the sister. The sisters came running to me and whined about it. Then when the sisters grew up, especially the two older ones, third one still is a good girl who doesn't go out at all. When the two other sisters grew up, the three brothers became so disgustingly protective about them. They couldn't even look at a boy or speak to a boy. They would get literally surrounded and say, who are you talking to? And they became frightfully protective about their sisters. And it was a normal brother-sister relationship, because I think, you know, it never was you're adopted and we are biological. It was never that at all. Because I think a lot depended on how we treated the whole family. So the whole family, we were one family. We weren't partitioned in the middle. We were one family. And I think if we were partitioned in the middle, mother and father would have gone to the last three. You know, because we were always that much more protective as well. And stupidly protective at some times. And like my youngest daughter often said, mother, you react, you don't respond, which is very true. As mothers, we tend to react more often than we respond. We should respond to situations, not react to them. But again, to come back to your question, you know, we didn't have the adoption problem, but we had lots of other teasing and worrying and bullying. That was always there, like any other siblings in any family. Yeah.
Fabulous. I think Mrs. Radha Nagesh is trying to say something. Please go ahead.
Sorry, Radha.
She's excited and she's waiting to say something. Go ahead.
So I fully endorse what Dr. Lobo was saying. And it all depends on how it is about attitude. It is about how you bring up your children. It's about how positively you talk about adoption. It is about, you know, talking about our children as, you know, we wanted them. It has been our decision to expand our family this way. So, you know, to feel wanted, to show that this, our children are ours. It is, and again, who's the adult in this relationship? It's we. So we need to do that little extra hard work. We need to put in that little extra and not just react, but respond. That was beautiful, Aloma. Thank you so much. That was beautiful. That is where we need to be. Yeah.
Super. All right. So before we conclude, Sandesh Aure, one salpa information about, you know, about any Yes, Dr. Irma.
There's one thing I would like to say before we conclude. I just want to give you one little fact about why pre-adoptive counseling is so important. You know, I had 3 biological children. I had adopted 2 children. I was chairperson of a voluntary coordinating agency, adoption coordinating agency. I wasn't yet chairperson of CARA. And I had all these seminars and talks to which I had given. And yet, when the time came for us to adopt our third daughter, the agency said, counseling, home study, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And my nose was totally out of joint. I said, I've done so much of it myself. And she said, no, you're adopting a child. And you know, I went for the home study. They came home, they did the home study, rightly so. And they did the counseling. And it was, and I think that has stood us in so much good stead. Because education is dynamic. Experiences are dynamic. You grow till the last day of your life. And I think, and I'm so grateful to Mrs. Chandy at that time, who insisted that we go through days and weeks of counseling, which was good. It stood us in good stead. So there again, you're never too educated to go through pre-adoptive counseling. You never, it's a continuous process. Thank you.
Super. Thank you, Dr. Lobo. If there are parents listening, ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳಿದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಕೇಳಿ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ತೊಂದರೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲಿಂಗ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಹೆದರಬೇಡಿ, ಹಿಂಜರಿಬೇಡಿ. ನೀವು ಯಾವತ್ತು ಹಿಂಜರಿತಿರೋ ಅವತ್ತು ನಿಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್, ಅವತ್ತಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮು 100x ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಒಂದೇ ಒಂದು ಹನಿ ಇರೋ ಅಂತ ತೊಂದರೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಸಮುದ್ರ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಮುಳುಗೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀರಾ. ಸೊ ನೀವು ಮುಳುಗೋಗಕ್ ಮುಂಚೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದ್ರೆ, ನಿಮ್ಗೇನಾದ್ರೂ ತೊಂದರೆ ಇದ್ರೆ, ನಿಮ್ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನ ಸಾಕೋ ವಿಷಯವಾಗ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಮಾತಾಡೋ ವಿಷಯವಾಗ್ಲಿ, ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದ್ರೆ, ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ತೊಂದರೆ ಇದ್ರೆ, ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲರ್ಸ್ ಹತ್ರ ಹೋಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡಿ, ತಪ್ಪೇನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೈಕಾಲಜಿಸ್ಟ್ ಹತ್ರ ಹೋಗಿ ಮಾತಾಡಿ, ಏನು ತಪ್ಪಿಲ್ಲ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನಾವ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಮೈಗೆ ಹುಷಾರಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋವಾಗ ನಾವು ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ ತಕ್ಷಣ. ಒಂದು ಕೆಮ್ಮು ಜ್ವರ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಓಡ್ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ. ಇದು ಯಾಕೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಅಥವಾ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗ, ಎಮೋಷನಲ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜಸ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲರ್ಸ್ ಹತ್ರ ಹೋಗಲ್ಲ? ಮೈಂಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿನ. ಅದು ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಯುನೋ ಆನ್ ಸಮ್ ಅದರ್ ಅಕೇಶನ್. ಬಟ್ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಕೇಳೋದಿದ್ರೆ, ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟಿವ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲಿಂಗ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಕೇಳಿ. ನೀವು ಕೇಳದಷ್ಟು ನಿಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಇವಾಗ ನಾವೇ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರೋ ಹಾಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ನಾವು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ. ಈ ತರ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳು ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಜನರ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇರಬಹುದು. ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಪ್ರಾಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹತ್ರ, ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಈ ತರ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ತಲೆನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಕೇಳಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಕೇಳಕ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಕೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದು ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿರಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವುದು ಒಂದು ಸಮಯ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿರಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿರಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸಕಲ ಒಂದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಇರುವಂತ ಒಂದು ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಅವರು, ನೀವು ಏನೋ ಹೇಳಕ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಇದೀರಾ ಅಂತ ನನಗೆ ಅನ್ಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ.
ಇಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಮುಂಚೆ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ, ಮಗುಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ. ಅದು ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ನನ್ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಅದು ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಅನ್ನಿಸ್ತು ನನ್ಗೆ. ಅದನ್ನ ಒಂದ್ಸರ್ತಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡೆ ನಾನು.
ಹೇಳಿ.
ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಇದು ಮಗುಗೆ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳೋದು ಮಗು ಬಂದ ದಿವಸದಿಂದಲೇ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ನನ್ನ ಪ್ರಕಾರ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಮಗುಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಲ್ಲ, ಮಗುಗೆ ಒಂದು 3 ತಿಂಗಳು ಅಥವಾ 2 ತಿಂಗಳು ಮಗು ಇದ್ರು ಆಗಿಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ನಾವು ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಕಂಫರ್ಟಬಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು. ನಾವು ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೇಳೋದಿಕ್ಕೆ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿಯಾಗಿ ನಾವು ಕಂಫರ್ಟಬಲ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು. ಆಗ್ಲೇ ಅದು ಮಗು ದೊಡ್ಡದಾದಾಗ ಕಂಫರ್ಟಬಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಕ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಮಗು ದೊಡ್ಡದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಈ ತರ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಇರಲ್ಲ ಅದನ್ನ ಹೇಳೋದಿಕ್ಕೆ. ನಮ್ಗೆ ತಡವರಿಸ್ತೀವಿ ಆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. ಬಟ್ ನಾವು ಸಣ್ಣದ್ರಿಂದಲೇ ನಾವು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ, ಇದು ಟಮ್ಮಿ ಮಮ್ಮಿ ಅಥವಾ ಕೃಷ್ಣನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಸೀತೆ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಚಿಕ್ಕಂದಿನಲ್ಲೇ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮಗು ದೊಡ್ಡದಾದಾಗ ಅದು ತುಂಬಾ ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಲೋಬೋ ಹೇಳ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಫ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅಶೇಮ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹೈಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ನಮ್ ರಾಧಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಹೇಳ್ದ ಹಾಗೆ, ನಾವು ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಮಕ್ಳಿಗೆ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ನಾವು ಸುಳ್ಳು ಹೇಳ್ಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತ. ನಾವು ಈ ಆ ಮಗು ಜೀವನದ ಒಂದು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಹೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದೊಂದು ಸುಳ್ಳಾಗಲ್ವಾ? ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಆಗಿ ನಾವೇ ನಾವು ಸುಳ್ಳು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಮಗುಗೆ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಕಲಿಸ್ತೀವಿ? ಅದರಿಂದ ಆ ವಿಷಯನ ನಾವು ಮುಂಚೆಯಿಂದಲೇ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅದು ಅಡಾಪ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದು ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ನೇ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಒಂದು ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಿದ್ದೆ ಅಷ್ಟೆ.
ತುಂಬಾ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಅವರೇ, ತುಂಬಾ ಸಂಕ್ಷಿಪ್ತವಾಗಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿದೀರಾ. ಇನ್ನೇನಾದ್ರೂ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದೆಮ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಮಿಸಸ್ ನಾಗೇಶ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಲೋಬೊ, ಅವರಾಗಿ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಕಾರ ವೆಬ್ಸೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಮಾರು ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಇದೆ, ಯಾರಿಗಾದ್ರೂ ಸಹಾಯ ಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಕೇಳಿ. ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಗೆಟ್. ಆಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸರ್, ನೀವು ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಟಾಕ್.
ಹಲೋ, ಹನ್ನೊಂದುವರೆಯಿಂದ ಹನ್ನೆರಡುವರೆ ತನಕ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟಿವ್ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲಿಂಗ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಅರ್ಥಪೂರ್ಣವಾದಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಸಂವಾದವನ್ನ ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಲೋಮಾ ಲೋಬೊ ಅವರು ಹಾಗೂ ರಾಧಾ ನಾಗೇಶ್ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಅವರು ಕೂಡ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಈ ಸಂವಾದವನ್ನ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಕ್ರಿಯಾಶೀಲವಾಗಿ ಚಾಲನೆಯಲ್ಲಿರೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸುಜ್ಯೋತಿಯವರು ಕೂಡ ತಮ್ಮ ಅನೇಕ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳ ಮೂಲಕ ಇದನ್ನು ಜೀವಂತವಾಗಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈ ಸಂವಾದವನ್ನ ಬಹಳ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ನಡೆಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಲೋಮಾ ಲೋಬೊ, ರಾಧಾ ನಾಗೇಶ್ ಹಾಗೂ ಸಂದೇಶ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸುಜ್ಯೋತಿ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ICTS ಪರವಾಗಿ ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು. ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
ಸೋ ಮಚ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್.